Hello guys, this is Leo the Wise, giving to all men, their needed uprise.
Hello men, dear boys. This time I want to share a subject that I have seen on MGTOW.com. It talks about the futility of arguing with women as a man. This is the first part of the video. Find it below as follows. Men and women are after different things when we debate. Men tend to, but not always, hold the truth to be the decider of the debate. Mongin is accepted, thus the name. The man who illustrates the truth the best is generally considered the winner of a debate. Women, not so much. And don't forget, women scoff at our schoolyard rules. Nothing seems sillier to a woman than the male code. When women fight and argue, there are no rules she adheres to. Women decide who wins a debate by who has been the snotty mouthiest and by who emotionally manipulates the other into submission. The truth matters not a bit to women. If men are always more or less deceived on the subject of women, it is because that they forget that they and women do not speak altogether the same language, and that words have not the same weight or the same meaning for them, especially in questions of feeling. Whether from shyness or precaution or artifice, a woman never speaks out her whole thought, and moreover what she herself knows of it is but a part of what it really is. Complete frankness seems to be impossible to her, and complete self-knowledge seems to be forbidden her. If she is a sphinx to us, it is because she is a riddle of doubtful meaning even to herself. She has no need of perfidy, for she is mystery itself. A woman is something fugitive, irrational, indeterminable, illogical, and contradictory. A great deal of forbearance ought to be shown her, and a good deal of prudence exercised with regard to her, for she may bring about innumerable evils without knowing it, capable of all kinds of devotion, and of all kinds of treason, monster incomprehensible. Raised to the second power, she is at once the delight and the terror of men. The Intimate Journal of Henry Amiel, December 26, 1868. Angry Harry made a really good comparison on his website once. Men love to watch sports. They will spend hours watching men kick balls, shoot pucks, pop golf balls, etc., etc. They will memorize stats, and they will see strategy everywhere in a game of sports. Men positively thrive upon these things, but women not so much. When women watch soap operas, they do the same things as men watching sports, except they do it for social strategy. Women see social strategy everywhere in soaps: how Kathy manipulated her love interest David into lying to his wife Ruth, causing them to have a big argument, driving David right into Kathy loving arms, and the affair begins. Social strategy. That why soap operas are popular with women. It what Cosmo magazine is chock full of: how to socially manipulate people. Socially manipulating people is what women do. In fact, it is one of the only things they do. Truth as men know it does not exist in the same way for women. Women are herd creatures, and thus women find truth or right and wrong through the consensus of the herd. It is what the herd believes is correct that women believe is truth. Thus you see, women are much more attuned to eternally changing notions such as fashion, or how they use social proofing the consensus of whom the herd finds a sexually desirable man to decide for their individual selves which man they find sexy. Men simply know what they find sexy in a mate, but women find men sexy because of other women's sexual preferences. Women may have happy ideas, taste, and elegance, but they cannot attain to the ideal. The difference between men and women is like that between animals and plants. Men correspond to animals, while women correspond to plants, because their development is more placid and the principle that underlies it is the rather vague unity of feeling. When women hold the helm of government, the state is at once in jeopardy, because women regulate their actions not by the demands of universality but by arbitrary inclinations and opinions. Women are educated who knows how? G.F. Hegel. When women argue, they are not trying to find the objective truth but rather are after manipulating the other S into feeling unified with them towards their opinion. If the herd believes 1 plus 1 equal 3, then it is correct because the herd believes it is so. If tomorrow, the herd believes 1 plus 1 equal 1, then that will be correct because the herd believes it is so. It is men who insist upon the objective truth based on principle and universality and continue to argue 1 plus 1 equal 2, No matter how much you cows moo at me, women are not after finding the correct answer, but rather they are after manipulating others into feeling they are right and their opponent is wrong. In other words, they are socially manipulating their opponent when they argue, rather than seeking the actual, objective truth. I think one of the absolute best things men can do with women is follow the advice of so many of those misogynists of old, and view women as children. A woman is the most responsible teenager in the house. Of course, it is not actually that they are children. It is more likely that they do not develop the same sense of principle and justice to navigate the world, because society enables them not to have to. Regardless of whether they are or not, I think in almost every aspect from game to simple conversations a man is advantaged by continually reminding himself that women are teenagers. They exist somewhere in between child and man. This does not mean a man can be foolish and disregard women as harmless children, for as Schopenhauer observes, women are naturally furnished with the tools of dissimulation, the behaviors akin to a pool hustler, and this feature is innate in women and is found as easily in the stupid as well as the very clever. Men should be very guarded when in an argument with someone who naturally dissembles, so that it will be found that the fundamental fault in the character of women is that they have no sense of justice. This arises from their deficiency in the power of reasoning already referred to, and reflection, but is also partly due to the fact that nature has not destined them, as the weaker sex, to be dependent on strength but on cunning. This is why they are instinctively crafty, and have an ineradicable tendency to lie. For as lions are furnished with claws and teeth, elephants with tusks, boars with fangs, bulls with horns, and the cuttlefish with its dark, inky fluid, so nature has provided woman for her protection and defense with the faculty of dissimulation and all the power which nature has given to man in the form of bodily strength and reason has been conferred on woman in this form. Hence, dissimulation is innate in woman and almost as characteristic of the very stupid as of the clever. Accordingly, it is as natural for women to dissemble at every opportunity as it is for those animals to turn to their weapons when they are attacked. And they feel in doing so that in a certain measure they are only making use of their rights. Therefore, a woman who is perfectly truthful and does not dissemble is perhaps an impossibility. This is why they see through dissimulation in others so easily. Therefore, it is not advisable to attempt it with them. From the fundamental defect that has been stated, and all that it involves, spring falseness, faithlessness, treachery, ungratefulness, and so on. In a court of justice, women are more often found guilty of perjury than men. It is indeed to be generally questioned whether they should be allowed to take an oath at all. Arthur Schopenhauer, On Women, 1851. I can well understand why in the old days, when there were such things as gentlemen clubs, that even all of the staff were male. Once a woman enters into a group of men, the group automatically becomes feminized. It also makes perfectly good sense to me why religions such as Christianity try to remove women from philosophizing about their doctrines, and they state that women are not allowed to speak in the church nor hold office or authority over men. They naturally lead away from the truth. Just because a woman says something that makes sense once, is no guarantee that the next thing out of her mouth also makes sense, and they all, by human nature, put the female needs before the male, and manipulate away from the truth with the ease, taking men along with them like the Pied Piper. Buddhism also says that women cannot become Buddhas for much the same reasons. When discussing matters, men and women are not even after the same things. Because women are based in relative truth, it does not matter how often you pin them down. As soon as you do, they create a new truth in their minds and just carry on, because her goal is not to find the truth at all, but that is what the man she is arguing with is after, and he thinks she is after truth too.
And that is it for now. If this content was entertaining and interested you, please share, like, and subscribe to this channel. I am the Swan, leading men till dawn, and even beyond. Thanks for the audience.